Good morning. It is so good to be here, but I want to tell you, I miss you. This church is empty and it's not the same without you. And I can't wait till we get back together. And I hope you feel the same way too. When we can come together and praise our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ together as a school in chapel. But for now, we are connecting in this special way. And so I'm glad you've joined me. And we'll begin like we always do with the call to worship. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, save us. Lord, deliver us. Lord, free us. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. Blessed are you, our King, Jesus. We'll begin with our first song, Amazing Grace, Your Chains Are Gone. This morning I want to talk to you about Holy Week. That's the week that we're in right now. It started with Sunday, Palm Sunday, where the crowds welcomed Jesus into Jerusalem. I'm going to read from Matthew chapter 21, verses 1 through 11. It says, as they approached Jerusalem and came to Bethphage on the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, go to the village ahead of you, and at once you will find a donkey tied there with her colt by her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, tell him that the Lord needs him, and he will send them right away. This took place to fulfill what was spoken through the prophet. Say to the daughter of Zion, see, your king comes to you, gentle and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. The disciples went and did just as Jesus had instructed them. They brought the donkey and the colt, placed their cloaks on them, and Jesus sat on them. A very large crowd spread their cloak on the road, while others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowds that went ahead of him and those that followed shouted, Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest! When Jesus entered Jerusalem, the whole city was stirred and asked, Who is this? The crowds answered, This is Jesus the prophet from Nazareth in Galilee. You know, that had to be an amazing scene. It says that the whole city went out to meet him. They lined the streets, they threw their coats on the ground, and then they waved palm branches and they shouted, Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest! Hosanna to Jesus our King. And so there they have it. They welcome Jesus into Jerusalem as a king. But then we read later on that Jesus isn't treated like a king. He's treated like a criminal. We continue by singing our next song, Lead Me to the Cross.
Redemption's here.
Things did change for Jesus after he entered into Jerusalem. After Jesus celebrated a meal with his disciples and showed them his love by washing their feet, that's pretty amazing, isn't it? Jesus, who is God, washes the disciples' feet to show them that they are to serve others. Do you know that's what we're supposed to do too? We are able to serve others because God served us. But then we read one of his own disciples betrayed him. You know who that was? For 30 pieces of silver. Yeah, it was Judas. And then he was arrested. And then we read that one of his disciples denied him, not once, but three times. He said, "Lord, I will never deny you. In fact, I will die for you." You know who that was? Yeah, it was Peter. Peter denied him, and he knew that when the rooster crowed. But then Jesus was then taken away to be crucified, and that's hard for us to understand because, again, Jesus is God. He is perfect, and yet it was God's plan, his plan for you and me, that his son would die take on our punishment. You know, I don't like to be punished, but I've been punished many times because of things I've done wrong, and I'm sure you've been punished as well. Do you like that? No. But we are so thankful that God, instead of punishing us, he punished his son Jesus so that through him we could have life. In Romans chapter 5 verses 6 through 8 it says, "You see, at just the right time, God's perfect time, when we were still powerless, Christ died for the ungodly. Very rarely will anyone die for a righteous man, though for a good man someone might possibly dare to die. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." Yet God showed us his love by sending his son Jesus, and Jesus died. Jesus, the perfect Lamb of God, died for the sins of the entire world, including your sins and my sins. But you see, the story doesn't end there. In Romans chapter 6, verse 23, we read, "For the wages of sin is death." That's what we deserve because of our sins. "But the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord." God gave us a gift on Good Friday. Jesus died for our sins, but then he gave us another gift on the third day on Easter Sunday. Jesus rose from the dead, and now he lives. He lives in us by his Spirit. And I pray as you celebrate this Holy Week, that you remember that God loves you so much. And now, because Jesus died for you and rose for you, he lives in you by his Spirit. To God be the glory. Remember, God loves you always. We now go to our God in prayer. Please pray with me. Heavenly Father, we do thank you for this day. We thank you for this Holy Week, where Jesus came riding into Jerusalem to do what we couldn't do, and that is to give up himself on the cross and pay for the penalty that each one of us deserved. Lord, we pray that you would continue to remind us of that wonderful gift, and we thank you that through Jesus you have forgiven us and you have given us life, and now you have filled us with your Spirit, and that you now live in us. Lord, we also pray for our students. We pray that you'd be with them as we are not together physically. We look forward to the day when we were gathered together in this place, where we will celebrate your presence among us. And so, Lord, we pray as we wait that you would be with our students, help them in their online learning, give them wisdom as they continue to learn and to grow. We pray for teachers. We ask that you would continue to use them with the gifts that you have given them to teach online, and we pray that they would be a blessing to their children as they have been for the last couple of weeks. And Lord, we pray for our parents. We ask that you be with them and help them to help their children in their schoolwork, but also bless their families as they spend time together. Lord, we thank you that one day we're going to gather together in this place and we're going to worship together as a family. We pray as we look forward to that day that you will continue to be with each one of us. Lord, we pray for those who are in the medical field, doctors, nurses, and all those who are serving in that way. We ask that you would be with them, keep them safe. We pray for all those who are sick. We ask that you would bring healing to them in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we pray that you would take away the virus so that we can get back together soon again. Father, we also thank you for all those who protect us and serve us. We pray for military, firefighters, border patrol, EMTs. We thank you for their service to us. We thank you that they are willing to give of themselves so that we can be safe and free. So, Lord, we pray for them, bless them, be with those who are far away, keep them safe, be with their families and give them what they need. And we pray that you would bring them home soon. And Lord, we thank you again for being our God, for loving us and giving us your son, Jesus, that through him we have life, because we know that not only did he die, but now he lives, and he lives in us. And so we thank you for that. We pray all these things in the name of Jesus Christ, who has taught us to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We now sing our next song. Know that God is with you and God loves you. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be and stay with you all. Amen. Go in peace and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen.